Hello all, this is going to be a short and sweet introduction because we're just going to jump straight into the footage analysis for our pseudo-monthly ballet roundup. If you haven't seen my first video about this, it's down in the description box below if you want to check it out. It has been about a month since I started it up again. The only notable update really is that I started doing an easier class so that I could refamiliarize myself with even like just the way that it feels more overall. I remembered the steps, but I didn't like it wasn't in my body yet last time. So I will be showing you footage from that easier class. I was initially gonna do the easier class and then do the harder one again for the video, but it's the same moves, like it's the same basic steps, it's just simplified a little, so if anything you'll be able to see even more clearly whether I've improved or not, I hope. So here it is. I haven't filmed it yet at this point, so I don't know what the results are going to be. I'm a little bit nervous that nothing will have changed, and that shouldn't be too surprising if that's the case because it's only been a month. So yeah, hope you enjoy.
All right, so last month's footage is on the left, current month on the right. The sides won't necessarily be the same. Sorry about that. The angles aren't the same. Sorry about that. We're doing our best here. Something we wanted to improve overall was the arch of the arm. I was keeping my arm too straight and hinging my wrist at the end to try and make up for it, creating this awkward hinge shape. I think I did improve that. It looks like my elbow is bent more and my wrist is straighter, which is nice. Although, I can't tell if my shoulders are hunched up because of the angle. Sorry about that. How's the stability on these dégagés on the right here compared to the left? Not too bad. Well, it was fairly stable in the other one too. Turnout isn't so great on my left side. I am very uneven there. Rond de jambe. What we wanted to improve with rond de jambe was keeping turnout as the leg extends to the back. You're about to see it here on the right. I didn't do it yet on the left, but I see as I'm going back, my foot is facing to the side instead of towards the floor, which is great. As you can see on the left, I don't think it was turned out to the side as much before. I wasn't paying as much attention to that, so I did improve that, which is great. But this is also my right foot instead of my left, which does tend to have better turnout. There's something with my left knee and the angle of it, like this line of my left leg isn't as straight as my right. Like my knee points more inward on my left leg. We all have different leg shapes. My left one's different from my right one. Anyway, this forward bend looks worse on the current month than the last one. However, could be the angle, and the back bend looks better on the right, I think. It looks like I'm going further back, doesn't it? It's also hard for me when my right leg is forward like this because it requires more of a stretch in my right hip, which is tighter than my left. Imbalance is everywhere. See on that lunge there I just did on the left, my foot was pointing straight down into the floor. I don't seem to be doing that anymore, even though I didn't do a lunge in this recent one. It's a similar thing. Closing it out. No penché this time. Can't compare that. Sorry. Fondue. What we wanted to see here was the legs extending, straightening at the same time, which I couldn't quite get last time. But let's see here on the right when I do it now. Can I do it? No. The left leg took longer to extend once again. So that is something we still have to improve. It's a strange thing for the mind to wrap itself around. I don't know why. It's just weird. And the turnout, again, could be better. It looks like I'm pointing my butt out. I looked straighter in the one on the left. I don't know why I've started pointing my butt more. Anyway, frappe. This time I was doing it without the bar, which is a little crazy. Well, I did it without the bar last time too, but I didn't show you that part. This exercise was a lot simpler than the last one, so I credit my stability here to that. This going backwards on the right there, it doesn't look great, but like for not holding onto the bar, it's not too bad. I'm surprised I didn't fall over. Trying our best to hold on here. The petite battement, I thought it looked better on the left than on the right here. I see I'm doing it on the right now. But that could have just been because I was on a releve on the left and I wasn't on the right. Could be the angle, who knows. Now, on the right, we're doing an arabesque with leg in attitude. That means it's bent like that. I would wish that my knee was up higher, facing more outwards to the side, and that my leg overall was higher. But alas, at least I landed this one, see? Whereas on the left here, when I was doing an extended leg arabesque, I just fell out of it awkwardly and then pretended to complete the exercise. Adagio, at ease. A cruel joke that you can be at ease during ballet, at least for the first 10 years, in my opinion. Even though I haven't done it for 10 years, but that's what I can foresee. Anyway, you see my foot on the right there? My left foot was pointing straight forward. It wasn't pointing out at all. The top of my foot needs to be pointing to the left wall. It was instead pointing up to the ceiling. What can you do? We really need to improve turnout on the left leg here. That is not something I have really improved on, I don't think. Maybe a little bit, but these things are so minuscule that it's hard to see, which makes me wonder why I'm doing this video in the first place. But here we are. We're seeing what we can see. I lost balance here on this arabesque. I was pointing out a little too much. My leg needed to be more straight behind me. And then doing this balance here at the end. So with adagio overall, did I improve much? Not really. Not that I can very clearly see. Maybe I got a bit more height. I don't know. And last one, grand battement. I never say that one right. What I really wanted to see was stability in the supporting leg and hip. Not bending the knee, not bouncing it around, like not shaking it around. It does look a lot more solid to me on this last one, this latest version on the right here, in comparison. Once again, it was a simpler exercise. I wasn't as confused as I was on the left, but it is looking better. And it didn't seem to be raising my active hip as much either when I was kicking up. And now the splits. So this is right leg forward, left leg back. It's filmed from the other side, so you get to see both sides of it, although I know that makes the comparison a little more confusing, but as you can see from this freeze frame, it looks like I did get lower. It really felt the closest it has felt for a while. And then on the left side, with my left leg forward and my right leg back, again, because of my left knee issues, because I had spent the previous day cross-legged for hours, I was worse this time than last time. I could not get low on this side at all. And to finish things off, we're showing you the side splits here. Even though you can't really tell, it looks like I could be doing a 180 angle here, but I'm really not. It's probably not that much bigger than a 90. But this is a nice little outro footage time for you. So overall, we improved a little bit on some things. Some things stayed the same. Some things were worse than the last time. But that's how it is, you know. Some days your left side's doing worse than another day. You never really know. But thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next week.